Today, I'll be tackling about Herbartian approach. Herbartianism. This teaching strategy or teaching approach is an educational philosophy, movement, and method loosely based on the educational and pedagogical thought of German educator Johann Friedrich Herbart. Johann Friedrich Herbart was a German philosopher and educator who led the renewed 19th century interest in realism and considered among the founders of modern scientific pedagogy. Herbart advocated for instruction that introduced new ideas in discrete steps. About a quarter century after his death, Herbart's ideas were expanded in two German schools of thought that were later embodied in the method used at a Parkis school in Jena, which attracted educationists from the United States. To facilitate this teaching strategy or teaching approach, Herbart advocated five formal steps. First, preparation, a process of relating new material to be learned to relevant past ideas in order to give the students a vital interest in the topic under consideration. Second, presentation, presenting new material by means actual experience. Third, association, thorough assimilation of the new idea through comparison with former ideas and consideration of their similarities and differences in order to implant the new idea in the mind. Fourth, generalization, a procedure especially important to the instruction of adolescents and designed to develop the mind beyond the level of perception and the concrete. Fifth, application, using acquired knowledge not in a purely utilitarian way, but so that every learned idea becomes a part of the functional mind and an aid to a clear, vital interpretation of life. These steps is presumed possible only if the student immediately applies the new idea, making it his own. This approach was formed because of Herbart's views in maintaining the dignity and the individuality of a learner for as long as possible throughout the education period. Herbartianism's purpose was to support students in their learning process, starting from no knowledge to full knowledge. So, I have here a sample lesson plan using Herbartian approach. Content standard, the learner demonstrates an understanding of key concepts of solving quadratic inequalities. Performance standard, the learner is able to investigate thoroughly mathematical relationships in various situations, formulate real-life problems involving quadratic inequalities, and solve it using graphic and algebraic method. There are three objectives in this lesson. First, illustrate the ability to solve quadratic inequalities using the graphic and algebraic method. Second, internalize the idea of solving problems in different methods. Third, correctly solve quadratic inequalities. The lesson we will be tackling is about solving quadratic inequalities. Students need to listen to the teacher and work in a group afterwards. We will be using graphing board as our material. And of course, we will use Herbartian approach in this lesson. We need to have preliminary activities through pre-assessment. Activity 1, student must recall the rules of inequalities. For the lesson proper, the teacher will demonstrate curve pictures to the students. After demonstrating examples, the teacher will allow the students to graph the given equation to review their understanding of quadratic inequality. Then they will be assessed through prepared worksheets individually. Afterwards, students will be asked with the following questions. How did you find the activity? Are you not confused about how to use the graphic and algebraic method? For generalization, What method can be used in solving quadratic inequalities? What are the steps that will follow in solving quadratic inequalities graphically? To evaluate students' understanding, they need to answer the following quadratic inequalities by using algebraic and graphic method. To expand their learning on the topic, the teacher will assign some problems to accomplish by solving the following quadratic inequality through graphing method. What is the advantages of Herbartian approach to lesson planning? First, it is simple and easy approach for lesson planning. Second, it is useful in the teaching of all school subjects. Third, it is incorporates the principles of learning. Fourth, it is logical and psychological approach of lesson planning. Fifth, it employs the previous knowledge of students for imparting new knowledge, so it is easier for the students to grasp the new knowledge. Sixth, it employs the inductive, deductive, and analytic synthetic method of teaching. And seven, it is useful achieving the cognitive objectives of teaching. Thank you for listening.